శ్రీవాసరంగ పరకాల మునిత్రయాప్త లక్ష్మాద్ భరక్షణమాంతం ఆచార్య భక్తి పరిపూత మార్గశీలం గోపాల దేశిక మునిం గురుమాశ్రయామః యత్ర యోగేశ్వర కృష్ణో తత్ర పార్థో ధనుర్ధరః తత్ర శ్రీర్విజయో భూతి ధ్రువా నీతిర్మతిర్మమ సంజయ ద ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ భగవద్గీత. Sanjaya Vacha, Sanjaya says, wherever there is Krishna and Arjuna, there will be definitely victory. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna Tatra Partho Dhanudraha Tatra Sir Vijayo Bhuti Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. He says, it is my verdict that for sure there will be victory wherever there is Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna. Swami Uttamur Swami writes a commentary here that he is not saying Krishna and Arjuna. He says wherever there is Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna, there will be victory. So that's what I was coming to the title which Mukund Swami has given. So we need to get out of the comfort zone. So when Swami mentioned this title, it was more appropriate and applicable for Adiyan. Because more often than not, Adiyan tries to copy and paste from Acharya's commentaries and try to babble and vomit whatever Adiyan consumes in a gibberish manner. And because of your abhimanam, there is a lot of encouragement and overwhelming support. However, Swami now wants to expose Adiyan and insistent upon exposing Adiyan's ignorance. So, to come out of the comfort zone, what I need to do? So, Adiyan just went through the Gita slokas and tried to read between the lines to come out of the comfort zone. Arjuna is not a spiritual person as such. He was a Kshatriya. He was just like you and me. I would say he was like you, not even me. Because Arjuna was always he was strong, he was intelligent, he was a dharmic person, virtuous, and he was born with a silver spoon. He was a king's son, prince. So, obviously, he has been the fortunate one to have Krishna as his cousin. So, but Krishna, they all knew that was basically a cowherd boy. He was brought up in Ayar Kulam. He had friends among the Gopikas and the Gopikas, and he was a Charach Chora Shikamani. He used to steal butter, and they all know his history. So Arjuna was kind of looking down upon Krishna, even though he was his close friend, cousin, everything. So, what happened? Even Yudhishthira had a doubt about should we at all go for the war? The cousins and the acharyas and the grandfather, should we go? He was telling Arjuna. And Arjuna said, come on, brother, you should not be worried about this because we have Krishna on our side. You should never ever feel demotivated. Because as long as there is Krishna, we have been seeing him how tactfully he is letting us come out of all troubles. Even though he is not that much brought up as much as we were brought up. Even though he doesn't seem to be as valorous as we are. So Arjuna had a bit of upper-handedness as compared to Krishna. And he was suggesting to Yudhishthira that Krishna is there, so no need to worry. So it was he who instilled confidence in Yudhishthira. And when things started, he was terribly confused because he saw at the middle of the battlefield, he was completely panic-struck. He was in total panic. And you and I have been in that situation very many times. Not even once. In every life turning moment, we are caught by panic, anxiety. And you should know that the every sloka when Krishna starts advising from the second chapter, Nasate Vidyate Bhavo, Na Bhavo Vidyate Sata, from then onwards until the last chapter, last sloka by Krishna, in the 18th chapter, every sloka is applicable for our day-to-day life. And Arjuna's life can be very beautifully compared with ours. In fact, if you see the third sloka, Pashyaitam Panduputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum Vyudam Tripata Putrena Tavashishyena Dhimata. Duryodhana is looking at the battlefield. Duryodhana is on the other side and he is watching how Pandavas have placed their army. And when he was looking at the army, he was perplexed. He was sweating. He was getting nervous. It's not only Arjuna who was getting nervous and was confused. It was Duryodhana who was getting more scared, more nervous. The previous night, Duryodhana was telling Dhritarashtra, when Dhritarashtra was asking, how are we prepared for tomorrow's war? Duryodhana said, don't worry, Pitashri, we are winning. Our army is the strongest. I am very confident that we will win this battle. You don't have to worry, Pitashri. He had such a confidence. He was full of beaming with confidence. Next day in the battlefield, the moment he looked at the Panja Pandava's army, he was shivering. And he says, Pashyaitam Pandu Putranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum. Ve Acharya Asiriyare, he was addressing Dronacharya, who belongs to Duryodhana's side. He says, Drupada Putrena, Drupada's son, the king Drupada's son, and Tava Shishyena, your Shishya, your disciple. Because Duryodhana is now beaming, buffering with anger on Dronacharya. He is an Acharya, he is a guru, and you need to seek his blessings before starting the war. He is, on the other hand, he is looking at him with anger. Acharya, your Shishyan, he is now placing the entire army so beautifully. It is you who has trained him with so much tactics, strategies. And now, look at him. He is coming back to us and he is going to fight with us. All because of you. Because Vyudam Dhridaputrena Tavashishyena Dhimata. Look, Pandparum, Pashya, Pashyaitam Panduputranam. Look at their army. Go and look. So, he was spitting venom. That time itself, the anxiety caught on him and he lost his control. Not that Duryodhana had control any time. He lost his control at this time very much. And then comes our guy, Arjuna. Arjuna was more confused. At least Arjuna understood that there is a problem with him. And he sought Krishna's help in rescuing him. Krishna said, don't worry. When somebody is demotivated, somebody is depressed, somebody is anxious, all that you need to do is to touch his shoulder, hug him and say, do not worry. This is not the way you should let yourself down. This is not your usual self. You are strong. You are a Kshatriya. You have learnt everything from Dronacharya. You are inferior to none. And so he started motivating him. So Arjuna, knowing fully well that Krishna was a cowherd boy, he was the one, the butter thief, and Gopika's darling. However, Arjuna at that time needed somebody to help him. And he is a charioteer who has been with him. He has been accompanying him throughout his life. So when he offered his solace, his words of advice, he started listening to him. He started paying attention with more focus. and he slowly began to understand because he was intellectual by nature. And you should, my point was to take this session, talk, into a different level. As the title goes, we need to come out of the comfort zone, and my intent is not to talk about Jivatma, Paramatma, Sharanagati and all that. Here, we need to enjoy the slokam number 30 of the third chapter. You may just take from your pages 3.30. The slokam, this sloka is a most wonderful sloka. It gives the secret of achievement. Krishna has given in those two lines what the psychology books can not give in hundreds of pages. What the psychologists cannot tell, Krishna has told just in two lines. He says, it's very simple. Mayi sarvani karmani sanyasyatma atma chetasa nirachir nirmamo bhutva yudhyasva vigata jvaraha. Mayi sarvani karmani sanyas adhyatma chetasa nirachir nirmamo bhutva yudhyasva vigata jvaraha. Nirashi, the desire. Nirashai, no desire. Means, once you have planned, you take for example the exams. You have planned, you have studied, you have attended classes, you have listened, you have prepared yourself very well, you have burnt the midnight oil, you have worked on all assessment papers, and you have done everything. But something bothers you because you have the expectation, the future, that you need to score 45 out of 45 in IB. You need to score 100 out of 100 in mathematics. You need to score this at a A star level. Otherwise, I'll be doomed. So, you have an asha, you have an expectation. You need to be ambitious like Arjuna. You need to have everything planned and work out the plan and keep everything ready, prepare yourself. However, at the time of the test, the exam, the battlefield, the project, the scheme, when you are in the midst of it, you should not look at the score, the 45 out of 45, the 100, the expectation, the success of the project. Do not think of that. You just need to deliver whatever you had learned. And that's what here he says. Here, nirashir. Do not have ashay. Remove the desire, remove the fruits from your mind. Just execute, nothing else. Focus on delivering the goods. And then, the third one, let's go first. Vigata jwaraha. Anadiyana manvinai vilangal yenavumo. Oh my God, whether my pen will work, whether I would remember what I had studied, whatever I left, two pages I left because of lack of time, would they ask questions from there? If I start this project, will it succeed? If I make this investment, there is also global pandemic now. Would the customers buy? So there are 101 anxieties. That would my boss be able to accept me, accept my work? Would he find fault with me? Because of the memories of the past, we get all this jittery. Very many times we have failed in the past. Very many times I have. I'm talking about myself. Very many times I have always wanted to achieve the first rank, but I always used to get only the fourth or fifth rank. Because I have always been getting fourth or fifth rank, I always used to shiver and get panicky in the exam that I would not be able to make it this time also. Because the guys who had got 1, 2, 3 in the previous exams and beat me are sitting in my front. And they are writing pages after pages while I am not able to. I look at them and shiver more. So, vigato jwaraha, jwaram, fever, anxiety and panic all these attacks. Why? Do not bother about it. Don't look at your, have the memories of the past. The memories of the past are gone, are erased. Now you are fresh. You have already prepared. You are fully equipped with things which, with which you can deliver the best. There is no way that the other guys who have prepared are having horns, are having wings for them to deliver. They are also just like you and me, the human being. So there is no way that they are superior to you, and you are in no way inferior to them. So just go do it. That is Vigata Jwaraha. No anxiety. There is no, the inspiration, the encouragement, the motivation gets dissipated because of these anxieties, because of these expectations. When you are thinking that, oh my God, I'm not going to make it, I'm not able to do it, I think I will fail this time also, it is definite I'm not going to make it, I think I will make it next year only, sure I'm going to fail. So all these things are only adding to our panic. Instead, you should say, what will happen? I have done my best, I will write my best, come what may, and then let's see what happens. So this is the way we need to think. Enormous inspiration gets completely dissipated. And when you are near the battlefield, like Arjuna, we shiver. Our knees buckle. And Arjuna was the strongest warrior. Dronacharya had always admired Arjuna's valor. Arjuna's throwing those arrows to the right focus. When he was focusing on the leaf, he could see nothing but only that leaf. He had that much focus, unlike us. Even then, he got confused because he had attachment. So, the attachment to the result, attachment to the people, and hence, you should never ever get entangled into the battlefield. You should just detach yourself and throw and fight against the enemies then and there. So the dissipation will not be there once you don't buckle. And then nirmamo, nirashir, nirmamo bhutva, yudhyasva vigata jwaraha. So nirmamo, here once I always do that. I plan, I never execute. Because we say, I have to do this, I have to study Tiruvayamoli, I have to do Ashtasloki, I have to write, give audio recording of these things, I think I should complete the recital of Achidram, I should practice Katakam. So all these things I start writing, but I don't do even one. Because by the time you do this, you do that, you always dilly-dally things and you say, I have so many things to do, I still have to do this, I still have to do that, and I end up doing nothing. So instead, take one task at a time, forget all others, devote some time, put your 100% energy, inspiration, encouragement, others' motivation into it, and then so instead of having nirmamo, how will I be able to do? How am I going to perform? I don't know how am I going to complete all these tasks within these 8 hours. I think they have given too much homework today. I would not be able to complete it. Always we complain that the teacher has given so much homework just because there are 2 days weekend. How am I able to do? But for every time when the kids complain this, within 3 hours they complete the entire homework and they say, it's done. And when you start, they say, I'm not able to do, with so much homework, I would not be able to complete during the weekend. So the kids get panicky because of the sheer, enormous quantum of work which they perceive. And every week this happens. Because they forget that last week they had panicked, but they completed. Anxiety hits. So it is for us to remind ourselves that we should not think that it is me who is performing. It is me who is who is going to act. So Krishna says, do not bother, just mayi samyasya, mayi samyasya sarvani karmani, all activities, all instruments that you do, any activity, small, big, even if you are mopping the floor, even if you are doing a small kaikaryam, even if you are reciting some slokam, learning some nyasadasakam, he says, don't think that, oh, the Sanskrit words are not coming to me. Do not think all these things. You are blessed with this opportunity of coming across these things, living these moments in life, only because we are gifted by the Lord with this intellect, with this discriminatory power, with these five sense organs, and with which we are born as so and so. I am born as Madhava Kannan not because I chose to be. I am born in this life not because I chose. It is Perumal, it is Krishna who had blessed me with this birth, who had blessed me with this intellect, who had blessed me with this five sense organs, with this discriminatory power, with this vivekam. And if I don't energize, if I do not utilize this intellect, if I do not utilize this vivekam, if I do not utilize these instruments which he blessed me with for anything good to the maximum level, it is a disservice to God if I don't do that. There are people who are much more intelligent than me, of course. There are guys who are in the college, in the school, they would say, I can do it, I don't have to study, still I get 90 marks. There are people who think, who can just grasp from the teacher and go right in the exam and pass. They don't have to work hard like me. They don't have to slog like me. Because we, the average student, need to work hard, at least to match, to do very well, to achieve whatever I've been trying. I need to work hard because the intellect level is different from people. So the guy who is much above average, above mediocre, the best, he doesn't have to study, still he gets good mark. But if you ask me what Krishna says, I am giving you intelligence, I am giving you that power for you to maximize to the best ability and deliver the best. If he puts on the same work which I do, he would go completely awestruck. He would go completely 100%, he will crack. So he can achieve, even sky is not the limit for such intelligent people. So I am telling for each Nama Rakash that you are born intelligent, you are born to win, and in order to achieve the maximum, you should put in more hard work. And Daivattal Ahadeninum Vayarchitan Mei Varutta Kulitaru. The hard work pays. There is no substitute for hard work. If you are asked to work a couple of hours for getting that result, put one more hour and write one more assessment paper. You would be able to simply crack it and you will get such a confidence. So, nirashir, nirmamo bhutva, and yudhyasya vigatachvaraha. Yudhyasya, go and perform the yuddham. Go into the yuddham, go into the battlefield, go into the life, and make sure that you deliver exactly what you had planned, exactly what you had learned, exactly what the Dronacharya taught you, your Acharya taught you. You will be achieving nothing but excellent result. Excellence will come to you automatically. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to even dream of it. The moment you start delivering, the end result is automatic. It would be excellent only. Adiyen, Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline, Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Danyasmi.